trash talking this year, it was really kind of limited. Pat took most of the abuse because he deserves it.
I worked up a heart.
But fine job. Let's get right to some of the categories. First of all, there's a couple landslide categories that we're gonna go into first. We're gonna talk about most likely to cause a cavity.
Yes.
Most likely to cause a cavity, number 13, which is number 13?
Right here.
Which is the pudding, cheesecake, chocolate, anything else that's bad for your teeth, pops on a stick. Pat and TC wins that category. You win no prize, just on this.
Just a shot.
It was a landslide win. We had another landslide in the taste better burnt category. The amazing thing about this is someone didn't vote for number 2. I think they got mixed up and put the numbers in the wrong pictures. But Pat Connor for his popcorn invention. Great job, Pat. Appreciate all the time and effort you put into that. We're not mentioning who got the one vote, but it wasn't even cooked, so I don't know. All right, the other landslide victory, there's actually 5 different people got votes, but the most inventive, number 14 got a couple votes. Where's number 14? Got a couple votes. Just want to point out who got some votes in this.
14 right here,
Banana Pops. Banana Pops, that got a couple votes. Number 13 got a couple votes. That was the Pudding Pops that already won a different category. Number 7 and 8 both got some votes. These are multiple vote getters, I'm just mentioning. Number 7 was the... 8 was... But those are irrelevant because Linda won the most inventive with the pizza slash cake.
No thanks. I've had enough.
All right, very close vote on the on fire category. The dishes weren't real hot, but they were excellent dishes. The hot dishes were excellent. Honorable mention, we're going to have to get dish number 4, which was the guacamole, I believe. Guacamole, that was Ellen. Ellen, the guacamole, excellent. But the winner of that category was the number 1, the salsa, which was what? Paul Hitler's sister?
Yeah.
That was from watching the
Mandy.
Mandy, good job. You win for on fire. You're not getting your name on the plaque, but that's not. All right, and the winners this year, the Good to the Last Drop, which is a nice name, by the way. That's a nice name for a category.
Colonel.
There were no votes for number 2. All right, some multiple vote getters that deserve some honorable mention. Number 8, again, number 8 was, they got a few votes. The pudding shots got Good to the Last Drop votes, too. They're all over the board. That's probably a pretty versatile dish. Number 6 got some good, got a lot of Good to the Last Drop votes. Which is number 6?
Cheers.
Number 6 is what, the
chowder?
Number 8 got some. Number 8? I did, okay. Number 14? What's number 14? That was the... okay. We actually had a tie for Good for the Last Drop, so I guess we're going to somehow figure out who's going to name it on the plaque, or maybe put both names on the plaque. But number 9 is one of the grand prize winners this year, which is... 9? Who's going to win?
Right up here. Porcupine.
Here
we go.
Porcupine. And number 11, which is the bouillabaisse, I believe, is also one of the winners this year. Charlene and Paul, both your names will go on this year's plaque. Hold up the plaque, Carol.
And the cook-off. Yeah.
Somehow we both your names on the plaque.
Please help yourself to more than eat. There's lots to go, lots to eat. You want to package some stuff up, back yourself out.